Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, a researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Today, I want to talk about which type of diabetes can be controlled by diet. After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new eBook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you can find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks. There are tons of diabetes friendly recipes for everyone. When it comes to diabetes, many people can get confused. There are, sort of, four types with two main types of diabetes. The main types are type 1 and type 2. Then there is pre-diabetes and gestational diabetes, which only occurs in pregnant women. So we really need to answer a couple of questions. First of all, which type can be managed with diet? Well, that's type 2. Now let's talk about those with type 1 diabetes first. If you have type 1 diabetes, then you are insulin dependent. When you were first diagnosed, you may have gone through what is called a honeymoon period, in which your blood sugar kept dropping and dropping and you used less and less insulin. You may have even stopped using it altogether. By the way, researchers now feel that type 1s need to continue small injections of insulin to protect what insulin-producing cells they do have even during that honeymoon period. But this honeymoon period will not last forever. If you have type 1 diabetes, then approximately 90% of your insulin-producing cells have been destroyed. They've not been damaged with a chance of repair. They are gone. It is impossible to reverse the damage done. While some think their diabetes has been cured or even reversed, this is a false sense of security. The process that destroyed the 90% of insulin-producing cells will destroy the remaining 10%. Ultimately, you'll be totally dependent on insulin. Type 1 diabetes cannot be managed without medication. And this is not my opinion. It's the opinion of the foremost diabetes center in the world, the Joslin Diabetes Center in Boston. Here's what they have to say on the matter. If you have type 1 diabetes, you must take daily insulin injections to keep your blood glucose in normal range. Your body produces little or no insulin. Insulin is a vital hormone that helps your body convert food into energy, and without insulin, you would die. So the answer is type 2 diabetes can be managed with diet. But is it something you should try to do? Well, here's what Joslin had to say about that. If you have type 2 diabetes, the answer to this question is much less clear. Many people can keep their blood glucose in a healthy range without medications, either oral diabetes medications or insulin injections, if they lose weight and keep their weight down, are regularly physically active, and follow a meal plan that helps them keep portion sizes under control and helps them spread the amount of carbs they eat at each meal throughout the day. So yes, it is possible for people with type 2 to maintain their blood sugar without medication. But I do want to emphasize this is not possible for everyone. In a 2016 study, 30 volunteers with type 2 went on a strict diet of 650 calories per day for 6 months. Now let me warn you right now, that is not a lot of food. 650 calories, whew, that's very low. However, the participants lost an average of 30 pounds. They had to keep this weight off for another 6 months through diet and exercise. The results were that 12 of those with type 2 who had been diagnosed less than 10 years went off their meds. For those who had been diagnosed longer, well, they did not have the same results. The key to managing your diabetes without medication is to lose weight and regularly exercise. And this isn't something you try for a month. This is a lifelong commitment. It can be done, but many people fail. You see, eventually many people with type 2 find that despite their best efforts, weight control, exercise, and diet just aren't enough to keep their blood glucose in a healthy range. It's not unusual. One theory is that some people's insulin-producing cells just get tired. They get tired from having to produce more and more insulin because their cells are resistant to the effects of insulin. Now, if your healthcare provider tells you you need to take oral meds or insulin injections to manage your blood glucose, I feel it's important that you follow their instructions. Keeping your blood glucose in a healthy range is key to preventing long-term complications such as eye disease with diabetic retinopathy, kidney disease, diabetic nephrology, heart attacks, and even other problems that poorly controlled blood glucose can cause over a period of years, one of which is, well, limb amputation. Now, if you want to try and manage your diabetes without medication, you must let your healthcare provider know that they know your intention and you need to be monitored and monitor everything very closely. Don't just wake up one day and say, I'll eat right and walk 2 miles, so I don't need to take my meds. That would not be a good move on your part. It is possible to manage your diabetes without meds, but do it the right way with the help of your healthcare team. Don't forget to get my new ebook. Please subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this one in the future. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.